Okay, so we're back. So hopefully you guys are, you know, sort of done marking.
Yes.
So don't worry, you guys will get it. You can always pause the video.
That's true. And also, Teacher Rinyo, we would like to invite you kids to take a picture of the markings that you've been doing, and you can send it to us.
Yeah.
Right? It would be fun for us. Not just fun. We would like to know how you are following or how you're able to do the markings. Okay? So take a picture and send it to us in our Facebook Messenger. Okay? So, or Viber. All right. Now, kids, Teacher Angel and Teacher Rinyo, we're going to go into discussion now. Discussion time. We're going to learn more about David and Goliath, particularly from verse 32 all the way to
verse 49.
That's right. We kind of, you know, want to focus on the important parts, right? Okay, so we're going to go, and I have with me here my journal. Okay, I did my learnings on this. So the first question we want to ask is in verse 32, Teacher Rinyo.
Mm-hmm.
What did David tell King Saul? What did he say?
Right, it says in verse 32, and David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him. Your servant will go and fight with this Philistine.
Okay. So when you say fail, it's actually like the men in that time, the men who were at war with the Philistines, and the Philistines had a champion with them, and that's Goliath, right?
Yes.
And fail means it could be like, you know, they were afraid.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
They were overwhelmed.
So they were overwhelmed, right? So why were the men afraid to fight or to face Goliath? Do you know who Goliath is, kids? Goliath is a guy who's like, you know, so tall. That's why I remember the markings.
Mm-hmm.
Teacher Rinyo told you to draw an arrow pointing mm-hmm. up, because he's even taller than you and I.
Right,
and even taller than your parents, so he could be like a giant.
Right. If you have your Bibles with you, you can go to verse 4, and it describes how Goliath, how uh-huh. tall Goliath is, and it says that his height was 6 cubits and a span. So that's very, very tall. I don't know exactly what the measurement is, so let's just assume he's like,
okay,
know, 18 feet or something like that.
That's right. Now, what did David offer to do instead when he, you know, had this conversation going already with
right.
Saul? What did he offer to King Saul?
So the last part of verse 32 says, your mm-hmm. servant will go and fight with this Philistine.
Wow.
So David found it in himself, and he said, I'm going to volunteer. I'm going to rise up to the challenge.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to face this giant.
Yes. So if you were to look at David, here's David. Who's David in the first place? My dear children, David is a shepherd.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as we trace back the mm-hmm. story of David in 1 Samuel, we mm-hmm. get to know about David. No? So I'm just giving you a background of David.
Yes.
David is a shepherd. He was the youngest in the family.
Mm-hmm.
And actually, the reason why he was there at the scene of the war scene was because he went to bring some food for his brothers who were soldiers.
Mm-hmm.
They were all, you know, getting ready to fight, or were in the battlefield already facing Goliath and the Philistines. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But David came, and he was so concerned, right? And he told King Saul that he will go and fight with this Philistine.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So he was volunteering to do that. He even said, your servant. When you say servant, you know, what comes into your mind? He said, I'm your servant. Right? So David was humble, a very humble person, right? He wanted to really help in ways that he can really help, right? He wanted to help. So he was humble. And many more. No, we could describe him later on. Now, in verse 33, what did Saul say to David?
And Saul said to David, you are not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for you are but a youth, and he has been a man of war from his youth.
Okay, so, Teacher Rinyo, what was the reason of Saul again?
Because David is just a youth, and Goliath is a man of war.
Okay, so kids, what do you understand when Saul said, you are but a youth.
You're young.
You're young.
You're inexperienced.
Yeah.
You don't know anything about the war.
So that's what Saul was saying, right? That you are a young man, you do not know anything about the war. Now, what's the difference? And then compared to Goliath, he was, you know, being in war for so long. All
it
his life,
since
he's been
his
there.
Youth.
Since his youth, he's been there. Now, what is the proper age for going off to war? So again, Teacher Angel, I did my reference
Good
searching.
Good job, Teacher Angel.
In Numbers 1, verse 3, it tells us that men 20 years old and up went out to war. So you could say that David was not even 20. He could be like 15 or 14 or 16, mm-hmm. right? So that's why Saul did not want him to go off to war. He was like a child.
Yeah.
And he was afraid that, you know, what match does David have with Goliath?
Right?
But what did David do? How did David convince King Saul?
So let's look at verse 34. Verse 34 says, "But David said to Saul, 'Your servant used to keep sheep for his father, and when there came a lion or a bear and took a lamb from the flock, I went after him and struck him and delivered it out of his mouth. And if he arose against me, I caught him by his beard and struck him and killed him.'"
Yes, so that is verses 34 to 36, right? Okay, so David convinced King Saul, kids, by letting him know about his experience, mm-hmm. right? He said, "My dear king, this is what happened to me," right? But actually, he wasn't boasting. When he was sharing, I was doing my observations here, teacher. When he was sharing, he was actually telling the king honestly what happened to him mm-hmm. and how he got delivered.
Right.
And he said there that the Lord delivered him, right?
Yeah,
the Lord protected him.
It says, "The Lord delivered me from the paw of the lion, from the paw of the bear, will deliver me from the hand of the Philistine."
Okay, so if you see that in verse 37, this is what we call the statement of faith. David had so much of faith in God, mm-hmm. and he gave back all the glory to God. He didn't take it for himself. He didn't say, "Oh, I just, you know, got the lion and the or the bear and mm-hmm. just stabbed it, or, you know, got it with his own twisted mouth or whatever." But what he did was he said that the Lord delivered me from the bear and the lion. And if he did that when I was tending to my sheep and my sheep got attacked, all the more, when I face Goliath, the Lord will deliver me also from his enemies, right? So he had such strong faith. You know, I'm really amazed, Teacher Angel, at David. David knew who his God was.
Right.
Kids, do you know who your God is? Do you know who God is? For me, I know who my God is. And I'm sure, Teacher Angel, you know who your God is,
yes.
right? He's always there for us. Like what we're experiencing right now, kids, we are experiencing the COVID-19, but we praise God that we keep hearing all these news about people being infected, people dying, but God's hand of protection is still around us. He's still protecting us, right? And we've been talking all about this. That's why we included it in the series of faith, because we get to see how strong David was in his faith.
Right.
And also, okay, if I'm going to look here, David took God at his word, right? He had not lost hope. He knows with all his heart that God will keep him safe. So again, kids, he knew who God was. He knew his God. God would not let him down. What God says, he will do. Remember the story with the disciples, when Jesus told the disciples, "Let us go to the other side mm-hmm. of the lake," right? He kept to his word. Jesus kept to his word. He took care of them. He protected them from the storm. But how is it that, you know, so the same way with David, David knew that if God took care of him, when he was tending to the sheep and it was being attacked, you know, David knew that God also will protect him yeah. when he faces Goliath. So isn't this amazing? And so just looking at our kids a while ago, I'm sure kids, you're brave and courageous, and we praise God for that. And we want you to be brave and courageous. I just remembered something, Teacher Angel. When we had the fire drill last year, I was so happy. You know why? Because I saw the kids as young as Jaisal. They were, you know, going out and, I mean, they were participating. They were volunteering to hold the nozzle of the tank, you know, to put out the fire. So that's bravery. That's being brave. And it's so good to know, kids, that as early as now we can be brave. As early as now you can be brave because of your love and your trust in God and your faith in God. So faith in God made David actually brave and confident. You know that, kids? And as I said, no, do we really know who our God is and is, okay? So first and foremost, kids, God is a very personal God, right? We also saw in the story last week that he took care of Elijah, and during the time of the famine, he fed him, and also the widow and her son, he took care of them, right? Mm-hmm. So that's so many things that's assuring. So God is real, right? God can take care of us. And just we had like a parent who got very sick, and we just praise God. The mom was sharing with me that now her husband is doing well, right? So God healed him and made him well. So kids, do you believe that God can deliver us from the COVID-19 virus? Yes, right? He can. We believe in all our hearts, right? So God can just say in one word, actually, he could just say it. Or he could just, like you said, Thanos, right, with a click of the hand, you know, he could totally wipe out the virus from the earth. The whole earth, not just the Philippines, but the whole earth, right? Okay, now let's go to verse 38 and 40. Why do you think did David, now David is in this situation, refusing to wear the protective gear of the soldier? Okay, Teacher Angel, why do you think? Could you read us that?
Verse 38, then Saul clothed David with his armor. He put the helmet of bronze on his head and clothed him with a coat of mail. Uh-huh. And David strapped his sword over his armor, and he tried in vain to go, for he had not tested them. Then David said to Saul, I cannot go with these, for I have not tested them. So David put them off. Then he took his staff in his hand and chose 5 smooth stones from the brook and put them in the shepherd's pouch. His sling was in his hand, and he approached the Philistine.
Wow. Okay, so we learn from there that he could not wear the armor of a soldier. It's too heavy. I'm just trying to imagine, like, if it was Miguel, and Miguel had to wear that armor on him, or even John, the armor of a man, mm-hmm. a full-grown man. Wow, it's going to be so heavy, right? It's like you're going to have a hard time moving with that armor. And how are you going to, you know, get the sword and, you know, like, fight Goliath, right? Mm-hmm. So David didn't want to use something that he wasn't familiar with. Right. And he said all he needed was his sling bag, right? His stick, his shepherd's stick, and also the stones. Mm-hmm. Take note of the stones. How many stones were there?
5 smooth stones.
5 smooth stones, right. That's right. And he also, most of all, even though he just had those things with him, as he usually carries around with him, he knew with all his heart that God would
defend him,
right? So that's what gave him the courage to go into the field. Now, Teacher Angel, what do you think how David was when he went, when he was, did Saul agree to let him go and fight Goliath finally?
Yes, because if you look at verse 37, at the last part of verse 37, Saul says, go and the Lord be with you. So he knew, he heard from David how trusting David was towards his God. And so Saul believed that, okay, maybe this kid does know what he's doing. Like, maybe the Lord will really deliver him right now. So Saul allowed him to step out into battle. So let's see what happens in verse 41. Mm. And the Philistine moved forward and came near to David with a shield bearer in front of him. And when the Philistine looked and saw David, he disdained him, or he mocked him, for he was but a youth, ruddy and handsome in appearance. And the Philistine said to David, "Am I a dog that you come to me with sticks?" Mm-hmm. And the Philistine cursed David by his God.
Okay. Thank you, Teacher Angel. So if we're going to summarize now or to summarize the character of Goliath, he was tall and mighty, a giant. And he was also proud and mm-hmm. boastful and yeah. arrogant, right? Because he kept mocking David and God, right? Mm-hmm. He said he made such a mockery out of that. Yeah. And David continued to stand his ground, and he wasn't afraid. I don't know about you kids, but teacher, just try to imagine. Let's try to imagine. What if Goliath was just there in front of us, that big giant, you know, facing us right now? Will we be able to, you know, just stand and just be calm like David was? I'm trying to think of an incident, you know, probably we could share an incident when we were just, you know, standing still and not being afraid. Oh, yes, I remembered one now. It's many, many years ago when I was stuck with floods, you know. I just came from my school in Manila, and I was, you know, could not go home because the floods was like this, okay, six under my chin already, chinny chin chin, and I could not swim because I don't know kids how to swim. But you know, in the midst of that, God just gave me that peace, because I even was carrying all my books with me, and God sent he touched the heart of someone to rescue me or to help me. And that someone even gave me her home to stay for the night till the floods went down. So, and then I could go back home the following day, a stranger that the Lord touched, you know, and how the Lord protected me. That's what I could think of. What about you?
Yeah, for me, I think it was my recent experience when I was still in college. I had my thesis defense, and that was very scary.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I felt like every day was very tiring, and when I finally had to defend my thesis, that was very, very scary, because you have to be strong, and you have to think, and you need to know your thesis very, very well. But thank God, because I was able to make it, because my God defended me. Mm-hmm. He went ahead of me, and now I'm here where I am today.
That's right. And we praise God, just like Teacher Rainiel, I am here today because I fear water, because I don't know how to swim, right? So I have fears of that. And I just remembered also, Teacher Rainiel, last December, our family had a trip to Taiwan. And when we were in the cable car, that's another thing about Teacher Angel, I don't like heights. And as we were in the cable car, I was just praying and praying. And I said, "Lord, you can deliver me. You can keep me safe. You'll take care of me." And the Lord just brought us through. He kept us safe because it was raining, right? It wasn't really safe because the cable car, you know, there could have been an accident because it was very wet, the slopes and everything. But the Lord just protected us, right? Because he honored my prayer. I was praying and saying, "Lord, keep me safe because I'm afraid of heights." And I just praise God that I was able to endure that length of travel, because it's very far to go to where we wanted to go, to the zoo. So we had to travel all the way from there all the way to the zoo. So we just praise God for how he did it. I'm sure, because kids, Goliath today would not be the physical Goliath or the giant.
Yeah.
I wanted to make that clear.
It's the many challenges that we go through.
Yes, that's right, Teacher Angel. The many challenges, the fears that we have, the challenges that we face, even the COVID-19 situation that we're facing right now is our Goliath, right? But we can keep on trusting God, keep on holding on to him and letting him know that we trust him. We know that he will deliver us. He will keep us safe, yeah. Right? So that's basically, David was not afraid. He just stood there calm. And even when he was being insulted, Teacher Rainiel, verse 5 to 47 is so beautiful. Could you read that for us?
Yeah, in verse 45, we see what David says. He says, "You come to me with a sword and with a spear and with a javelin, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. This day the Lord will deliver you into my hand, and I will strike you down and cut off your head, and I will give the dead bodies of the hosts of the Philistines this day to the birds of the air and the wild beasts of the earth, and all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel, and that all this assembly may know that the Lord saves, not with sword and spear, mm-hmm. for the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hand.
Wow. That's another declaration of faith. It's so beautiful. David declared before Goliath and all the Philistines, and not just them, but even before the whole of Israel, that when he said this, I come to you in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you made fun of. This day the Lord will deliver you into my hands. And he boldly declared that, David declared that the Lord will deliver Goliath into his hands. He wasn't afraid. And you know, he said, for the battle, this is what I really like, Teacher Radial, and this is the title or the lesson for our episode today, the mm-hmm. battle is the Lord's. Mm-hmm. So my dear children, it is never us fighting in the battle. It's always the Lord going before us, standing beside us, going in front of us, or carrying us through
yeah.
the battles, the fears, the challenges that we're facing, right, mm. kids, right, teacher? So that's the beauty of it. So we need to declare. And you know why David was declaring? Another thing, kids, is when we face challenges and fears, we're not alone. We need to remember that the Lord is with us. At the same time, when the Lord delivers us, there's that declaration of faith. We could share that. That's what we call testimonies. We could start sharing and letting others know. So they'll be blessed and they'll be encouraged that, oh, wow, that's so beautiful. The Lord took care of you. The Lord protected you. They'll get to know who God is, because you know already who your God is. And the Lord wants you to share it to others who do not know. And that's basically another thing that David did when he was standing facing Goliath, right? He was making it known mm-hmm. to everyone
yeah.
of who God is and what God is going to do. Mm-hmm. And what happened? God delivered him.
So verse 48 says, when the yeah. Philistine arose and came and drew near to meet David, David ran quickly toward the battle line to meet the Philistine. And David put his hand in his bag and took out a stone and slung it and struck the Philistine on his forehead. The stone sank into his forehead and he fell on his face to the ground. So we see here that yeah. David acted by faith also. He yes. knew, he was confident that the Lord will take care of him. So he just went and he did what he had to do, and he trusted that God would take care of him. So what do we learn here, kids? We have a God who goes ahead of us.
Yes.
We have a God who is with us every step of the way. So even if you're afraid, even if you're worried, uh-huh. you know God will take care of you. You don't need to be afraid. Yes, it's normal to be afraid, right? We talked about that in the first episode.
Yes.
But always trust in the Lord. Remember, take God at his word. And David trusted in the Lord that he will deliver him. And maybe you're in a situation right now. Maybe you're going through bullying. Maybe someone is hurting you. Maybe you're experiencing something very difficult right now.
Yes.
But we want you to remember that the battle is the Lord's. No matter what you're going through, God will fight that battle with you. God will be your ultimate hero. Mm-hmm. God will deliver you from whatever situation you're in, because our God can be trusted, and our God can create wonders even when it seems like there's no hope.
That's true. Thank you so much, Teacher Aniel, for sharing that with the kids. That's right, kids. You might be in a situation right now that's so difficult, or you might be sad, or your emotions are all, you know, all over the place because you're thinking, Lord, is this really going to end? I'm stuck at home. But kids, it's not going to be forever. The Lord wants you to know he's with you every step of the way. Just like when I thought I was going to drown that night, the Lord took care of me. When I could have been hurt by wicked men outside because it was so late in the night, God protected me. When I thought that I was going to, you know, fall off the cable car that I was in, that it might crash, God reminded me, I will take care of you. So kids, when we walk through the storm, when we go through the challenges of life and fears, it's all part of God's plan mm. to make us a better person, to make us strong in our faith, to build the character inside of us,
yeah.
right? So we may be superheroes, like we may love superheroes, but then superheroes also have their weaknesses.
Yeah, but God doesn't have any weakness.
That's true. So God is our ultimate superhero,
right.
And He will see us through. He will carry us
also,
through.
Also, don't forget to look back at the faithfulness of God. Remember what David did? He recalled what the Lord did for him when he was attacked by the bear and the lion.
Beautiful.
So whenever you're in a situation, always recall, what did the Lord do for me? Well, how did the Lord take care of me back then? And then remember what the Lord did, and then have that faith that God, who took care of you then, is also going to take care of you now. So there's no need for you to worry. No matter what Goliath you're facing, you can trust in the Lord, because there is no battle too difficult for the Lord.
Wow, I love that. It says there's no battle too difficult for the Lord. That's true. Wow, amen. Praise God, Teacher Angel. This is so beautiful. And we hope and pray, kids, when we come back, we just hope and pray that you learned something today, and not just something, but you know, it has always been our prayer that your faith will grow. You will really grow and blossom in the Lord, right? And you'll be the kind of person that God wants you to be. Continue to enjoy your walk with Him. So we're going to see you again in a while. We'll be back.